Hello everyone, today we are going to learn Strassen algorithm. In Strassen algorithm, we have basically two matrices X with elements A, B, C, D and other matrix Y with elements E, F, G, H. Then we have these seven formulas P1, P2, P3, till P7 and using these seven formulas we derive the product of the matrix X and Y. The complexity of Strassen algorithm is big O of n square. So the basic problem that we get is to how to learn these seven formulas in a fast way. So I have developed my own way to learn these seven formulas. You just need to remember these four points in order to learn and derive these seven formulas P1 to P7. First one is ahead. Make a note that the spelling is AHED, but you can learn it as ahead. Then we have diagonals. Diagonals obviously represent the diagonals of the matrices. Last CR and first CR. C represents here column, R represents here row. Okay. So now we have two matrices X and Y. We have these four points. And make a note that when we are looking for row, we will consider plus sign. And when we are looking for column, we will consider a minus sign. So first write P1, P2, P3 till P7 in your notebook. Then we will use our first point, that is ahead, AHED. Then we have diagonals. Diagonals here represent the diagonals of the matrices X and Y. We have diagonals AD. So we will write A plus D. And then we have diagonals EH. So we will write E plus H. Remember, the order matters here, so you have to write A plus D into E plus H in P5. Then we have last CR. C represents here column, R represents here row. We will look for the last column in X. The last column in X is BD. So we'll write B minus D. We have taken a minus sign because a column is considered here. Then last R. Last R in Y is GH. Since it is a row, we will write G plus H. Then we will consider our next point, that is first CR. First column of X is AC. Since it is a column, we will write A minus C. And first row of Y is EF. Since it is a row, we will write E plus F. We have completed P5, P6 and P7. Now we have to complete P1, P2, P3 and P4. Now consider P1. In P1 we have A. In other matrices, corresponding element of A is E. Since we are in Y, we have to check for columns. And the opposite column is FH. Since it is a column, we will write F minus H. Okay. Now consider P2. In P2 we have H. The opposite corresponding element of H is D. And since we are in X, we will consider four rows. The opposite row is AB. And since it is a row, we will write A plus B. Now consider P3. In P3, we have E. The opposite corresponding element of E is A. And since A is in X, we will check for rows. And the opposite row is CD. And we will use positive sign here as we are considering a row. So we will write C plus D. Now consider P4. The element of P4 is D. And the opposite element is H. Since we are in Y, so we will consider column and the opposite column is GE. And since it is a column, we will write G minus E. Now we have developed a way to derive these seven formulas. Now we will use these seven formulas to develop the product of these matrices X and Y. In order to learn this, I have developed my own way. You can just memorize it. First, I will write P1 plus P2, then P3 plus P4, because it is easy to memorize. Then I will use P6, P5, P4 minus P2. P6, P5, P4 are consecutive numbers, so it is easy to learn them. Then I will write minus P2. In the last, I will write P1, P5, P3, P7. All these numbers are odd, so you can club them separately. You can just derive your own method to learn this product of the matrices X and Y. A question of Strassen algorithm generally comes in end-term examination for 12 marks. So you can just use this method to memorize the formula of Strassen algorithm for your exams. Thank you for watching.